确实是这个样子，不是很，真的不是很容易，尤其，文化上都有很多不同。就很简单的一个例子，就是说吃饭，对吧？我想吃这个，他就不，肯定不喜欢吃，那怎么办？你就只能是做两种饭呢。
Well, certainly, without God, without love and forgiveness and patience and the fruits of the Spirit, it's going to be a lot tougher. So I would just say people should make it easier on themselves and allow for God to work in their marriage. But even that, it doesn't mean that every day is rainbows and sunshine of happiness.
神说要爱你的邻人像爱你自己一样，我觉得我的最大的最近的邻人就是我的丈夫。
You know, the background of having different cultures makes it difficult in different ways than other marriages maybe where they share the same culture, but that means I guess I need to try to understand where she's coming from with that in mind, and she has to consider from my point of view, and I have to try to understand her family, and it helps to get to know her family situation, family background, and for her, the same for me, trying to understand me.
首先你要尊重对方，很重要一点，就是要尊重他，照神的话行，这个很多问题才可以解决。若不然的话，很难能够合到一起去。
Then have God teach them the patience and love for those things, and you know, people generally can't change other people, but God can change people to work together more. The situation is the same for us. So we just have to pray and work together a little bit differently than.Maybe those who are coming from the same background.
我觉着生活了十多年在一起之后，我觉着很重要的，每一个家庭肯定都有因为人都是不一样，神造我们就不一样，所以每一个家庭可以有自己的问题。我觉着，有一个 universal rule 就是夫妻之间就是一定要互相尊重，你要彼此尊重，就是 respect each other。没有 respect， 那我觉得就很难再讲其他的东西了。
It's you know, we have the joy of Christ, and we have the joy that we can work together and love each other. But part of loving each other, of course, is being patient with each other or trying to pray for each other in difficult times.